Ajay, Saif, they say the reason to look back, the reason to reflect on history is that the past defines the future, or the past informs the present, maybe. What was it about this story that you feel has a relevance in today's times? Or why was it a story that you wanted to tell today?
It's not just the story. Right. But before we started Tanaji, we decided to start a franchise, a series called Unsung Warriors. See, the problem is, our history, if you read our books, Tanaji was a very small chapter when we were kids. Mm. It's not there anymore.
Correct.
Even that one paragraph is not there anymore. Mm. So I feel what has happened is, now also when we're doing Tanaji, it's like, okay, he's from Maharashtra.
Right.
He's a big hero here.
Correct.
Okay, a local legend.
Correct.
But he's actually not local. Whatever he's done for the country.
Right.
Okay. And if he wasn't there, the whole map of India would have changed. Aurangzeb started from Delhi. He wanted to take over the whole south, and this is where he stopped.
Right.
Kondana was taken back. But nation doesn't know about it.
Mm.
So the problem is, we have so many states and everything is so divided that people who've done so much for the country,
correct,
the country
doesn't know. They become heroes only in their own region.
And not,
right.
So this is why we started that, if they've done such great things, the whole country should know. I think the whole world should know.
Sure.
And Unsung Warriors, okay, the first story is Tanaji.
Right.
The second would be from some other state.
So you see this as something that you
intended. Exactly, exactly. Lovely. Amish Tripathi.
Yeah.
A good friend of mine. So when he came to know about Unsung Warriors, and he's with us, and he said, if you've started this series, I have just finished a book, which is not out in March. Uh-huh. So he gave me the book to read. Let's make this as the second of the, it's about, it's Sohail Dev, Mohammad Ghazni.
Okay.
And what a story he's written. Nice. So that is what we are looking at second.
Right.
Well, that's
about who?
10th century.
Ghazni?
Sohail Dev, Ghazni. He raised down the Somna temple, mm-hmm. and then Sohail Dev fought, and then, he rebuilt the temple.
To each of you, what were maybe the qualities of this story that felt relevant? I mean, Ajay, of course it's about history, and of course it's about celebrating the unsung heroes, but also those sacrifices were relevant for the country that we live in today.
In any culture, Rajeev, you basically look for a hero, you look for something to fight against, you look for something to defend.
Right.
I think the idea behind this movie is to kind of celebrate the hero and honor the hero, as well as entertain the audience.
Right.
So we create a thing. In Western culture, for example, there was a whole lot of films about World War II at some point.
That's right.
So in our culture, there's a lot of films about, particularly Aurangzeb's time, because he's considered to be a Mughal a sort of ruler who was quite autocratic and kind of pushed the whole idea of religion to a large extent and created those divides.
Right.
And the government has also decided to take his name off a road and has become a bit of a villain in our culture. So we are also kind of catering to that and dealing with that story. Tanaji also I read as a kid, an Amachitra Katha comic, and there's this really famous story about, this fort and this big cannon.
Correct.
And in many ways, it's like Guns of Navarone.
Right.
Or, Where Eagles Dare, where these guys go on a crazy...
A mission, right.
Yeah, like a surgical strike.
Right.
And the fact that it can also have a political relevance today and it resonates with the politics of the time is great for people trying to make the movie and to sell that.
Right.
But at the core of it, it's a great story in itself about a hero who gives his life to fight against oppression.
Right.
And whatever color that oppression takes, or whatever name we give it, basically this is the idea.
Yeah, and it's about invasion. It's about invasion. It's about fighting foreigners.
Mm.
It's nothing to do with religion.
Mm.
And also I feel what has happened is our history is forgotten from the textbooks.
Right.
And I think why it is forgotten, it was made to forget by the Britishers.
Yes.
Okay.
Right.
So before that, we used to talk about our heroes and what freedom, how they fought for freedom. Britishers didn't want you to fight.
Right.
So they removed all that. And then we've been following those textbooks after that. So we've never realized that we need to go back. When we're studying history, 80% we're studying foreign history.
Right.
Okay. There should be a balance of 50-50 at least. You need to know the world, but you need to know your country also.
Right.
And people like Tanaji, the sacrifices they made, their families have made, We all can't do it.
He put his son's marriage on hold to go off to...
So the kind of sacrifices they made, I'm not saying we can do, we cannot do it. But we can get inspired and strike a balance that you love yourself, you love your family, and you love your nation also. If everybody strikes a little bit of balance, I think we're a sorted country.
Right.
And we're a sorted world.
You know, the trailer also sort of... what's lovely about the trailer is that it's not typical in the way that we tend to look at historical films, you know, Sword and Sandals or your standard kind of... It actually looks like a thriller. It's actually shot. I mean, the dark colors. And it seems sort of lovely because it's the story of the recapture of the Sinagar fort.
Yeah.
Was that sort of deliberate? And your director is an ad filmmaker, apparently, who's...
No, he's not an ad filmmaker. Okay. But his first one was Lokmanya.
Right.
It's a very
small. So he's familiar with the history of the... Correct.
He is very familiar with the history.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
He's very good with that. And the intention to keep the film in this format was always there. And we needed to keep it edgy and things like this. So that's how...
We're all influenced to a certain extent by world cinema, especially absolutely artistic makers like Om, who's, I think, brilliant. Right. In this. And he... there's different tones to the film. I mean, Ajay's portions and are the parts that are kind of warm and reddish, brownish, yellow,
right,
more earthy tones.
Right.
You know, in a way, because he's like introduced, I think, tilling the ground. He's working on the soil.
Son of the soil,
so
right,
he's like that. Whereas, you know, since I'm playing the antagonist, it's kind of blue and cold and very kind of gothic,
right,
in many ways. So you can actually see that, and you can see that in the posters and the treatment.
Yeah.
So the camera work, the action choreography, the way this film is shot is the most artistic thing I've been involved in till today. I mean, this is a really big scale. It was like being in the Avengers in a way, because a lot of it was done later.
Right.
And when we're on set,
sure,
you know, we weren't sure what it would look like.
Right.
But later it looks absolutely incredible.
How did you react when they first offered you this part? I mean, have we gone past that stage where actors worry about, oh, I'm a leading man, should I be playing antagonist? And if you are, what are you looking for that makes you, you know, work on that?
The world has changed, acting. I mean, everybody obviously sees different stages, you look at it differently. But the way I am right now, I'd be really happy just to have an interesting job as a, you know, what is the role and what are you playing?
Right.
I mean, when I was a kid, I used to look up to Johnny Depp. Now I think an actor like Tom Hardy in the West,
sure,
I mean, who plays villain in, you know, Batman,
correct,
and hero of Mad Max, and then a small web series also.
Sure.
So anything, I'm kind of platform agnostic.
Yeah,
this role was outstanding.
We all want to do that. I mean, we need to grow. We need to we need to enjoy our work. You know, not keep repeating ourselves.
Right. I said I'm too excited when I got offered it, and I told the director, give me like 3 item scenes. And he gave me like 12. So
I love the bit in the trailer where you're yelling. It seems like you're screaming at someone, and he's falling off the edge of the cliff
or
whatever.
It's quite astounding. They're all items. So this director also, and obviously Ajay, the idea, they know how to entertain the audience. You know, so it's a larger than life. It's a family experience. This is something you can go and watch.
Right.
And there's a lot at work. So, you know, when we talk about history and the politics of it,
correct,
there's also a great, I mean, basically it's a great movie.
Right.
That's the reason you make it also.
You know, this story also has a lot of mythology attached to it, isn't it? Isn't there that story of them the Maratha troops sending up that lizard?
So what we've done is, we've given a logic to it, like we've not exactly kept the lizard.
Correct, because we have to show that, right?
Hear
this and you go like...
Exactly.
But it's a bit far-fetched. It's a good call to avoid, to change.
No, also what is happening is, but sensible people, they're saying, I hope that is there.
Right.
But when they see the film, I hope they...
No, but the kind of reference we've given of it in the film, I don't want to talk about it, but you'll know that we have not ignored anything.
You haven't forgotten it, right?
Yeah. So it's there in a different way.
Right. You know, the two of you, I mean, y'all first worked together, what, 20 years ago? Kachhe Dhaage?
Yeah.
Was that the first time?
Yes, I think so.
More than 20, no? Or 20?
I don't know.
99 was the year that it came out, but at that time it used to take a while to make movies.
20 years.
That was such a good film. I remember the music of that film was fantastic. Again, it was, you know, it was beautiful, shot in the deserts.
The film was good, the music was extraordinary, and the most important is we had so much fun.
We had a lot of fun.
We were like...
Do you have memories?
Yeah.
Yeah, lots. We can't share.
It was a beautiful, well, I'll tell you, we were handcuffed together for a lot of the movie.
Right, right.
And then there was a large patch, and I think I was sitting there quietly, and he was, as usual, brooding quietly.
That I believe, you sitting so, quietly.
Yeah, I also
sure
was sitting quietly. So he looked at me and said, well, if you're going to be like that, we'll get along. So I said,
start
all right.
Start a beautiful friendship.
Just hang around.
And then, of course, you all did Omkara in 2006, which really is one of those films that people love and remember so fondly. And again, that was such an incredible part for you. It really changed the way that people looked at you. Do you have memories of making that film again? Such an incredible film.
Yes, we do.
Yes, I remember
a lot of it.
I remember. I mean, everything. Most things I remember.
We were shooting in Mahabaleshwar.
Yeah.
We had a great time there.
Yeah. We've always...
What is the basis of this friendship? You know, I would imagine, like, is it silences? Is it the long silences?
I think we've had a few chats.
It's just silences. It's a lot of rubbish.
Right.
We talk a lot of rubbish.
Okay.
And there is no problem that if, I mean, this. I don't feel if I say something rubbish to him,
he's going to judge you.
Yeah, he's going to judge me. And I don't think you feel the same because that's what started in Kachhe Dhaage. We were only talking rubbish whenever we spoke.
And we're quite honest, you know, and there's no bullshit. So in that sense, you know when, because there's so much that can be bullshit in our industry.
Right.
You know, there's people can get egoistic, carried away, this, that.
And it's very, very, it's very rare that you can be completely yourself with some people who know you, they're not going to judge you. So that's how we hit
that's
it off,
right.
I
yeah.
think.
Right. You know, does it also stem from a security? You know, so much we've heard, and I think, of course, it's changed, and I think the times have changed, but it's true. I mean, you all have all done two-hero, multi-hero films. It also stems from security, just, you know, the thing that everyone says about Ajay is that, I mean, he's completely secure. You never have to worry about him hogging lines, cutting, I mean, there are actors who have that reputation. He's not that guy. Does that, I mean, when you're doing a film like this, or the films that you all did together, Omkara was a multi-star in that sense, does that, even on a subconscious level, an unconscious level, play that I'm comfortable
No,
here?
No, it's not subconscious. It's extreme. It's very, very conscious that you feel secure. And he has a reputation for being a generous actor and a relaxed actor, and someone who will allow someone else to have his moment and to shine also in the film. Probably because, you know, he sees it in a, holistically as a producer, that a good contribution is a good contribution.
I know, as a film. I mean, if the film doesn't work, nothing works. And for a film to work, everybody needs to work.
So then why are some actors insecure? Is it because they're just not particularly looking at the larger picture?
No, it is an insecure profession sometimes for people, you know? If you feel, oh God, this guy's got better lines than me, it might make you feel... So who's to judge? I'm saying in his movies he gives me great lines, so I've never felt... I've never felt shortchanged. I've always been happy.
Sure. For both of you, what were the challenges that this kind of film poses for you as actors? I mean, it looks like it would be physically taxing. It looks like, I mean, more than your usual modern film. I mean, there's plenty action, there's costume.
You're physically taxed. You were.
Right now.
More taxing when he has to talk about
it. It must be exhausting working on these...
No, I've been working day and night right now, so...
Sitting on the...
The final color correction.
Right.
So, okay, I'll tell you then. I think they got the kind of action choreography in this film was so detailed and so cool, you know.
It shows. You know, the scenes where you're swinging off the ropes and stuff, it shows.
It's very logical also.
But they've got, like, the people doing it, you know, would tell us, your foot here, your hand here. So that was physically taxing.
Right.
You know, doing this kind of heavy-duty sword fighting.
Right.
It was pretty tough stuff in the film.
But you're an action hero. You do it all the time.
But apart from that, also there comes a lot, when you're doing a film like this, there comes a lot of responsibility. A for one, when you say that, you know, when you start collecting data from when you're making a Tanaji or some historical character, so all the information is not there.
Yeah.
You have to imagine a lot.
Yeah.
And you know that you are going to get flack for a lot of things because everybody thinks differently.
Correct. Everyone has an impression of these.
Yes.
Right.
Like we were talking about the monitor lizard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct.
So when you have to imagine things and how what they wore and how they wore, because that you don't.
Correct.
Have
references. There's no
that.
Reference. Yeah.
So you have to stay on track, but keep your imagination alive and, you know, create the drama and like Saif was saying that. The film needs to work. The film needs to entertain you. Entertain you in the sense, in whatever form. Not laugh, but, I mean, connect with you.
Yeah.
So then you have to create the drama also.
Right.
So you have to be on that edge, you know,
yeah.
where you're not stepping on the other side also, and you're still, it's like the start, middle and end.
Yeah.
What is in between?
Correct.
You know, what is the approach? If they fought a war, how did they fight it?
Right.
Okay, they went up quietly. It was a guerrilla warfare. Mm. It was a surgical strike.
Mm.
But what was, how did they manage to get in?
Right.
How did, all that is not
it's
there.
Not there, correct. So you're filling in those gaps in a sense. Yeah.
You have to. Every filmmaker has to who's making something in his
yeah. because and avoid getting in any controversies.
Exactly. Right. Exactly. Well, you still will. You
yeah,
still
yeah,
will.
I'm sure.
Like
yeah, you can't please it.
Yeah, like somebody is talking about it and they're creating issues that he was from my caste or whatever. Mm. He was an Indian.
Yeah.
He fought for the country. How is it relevant that, why do I need to show that, oh, especially he was from this caste?
Right. As long as you're not showing that he was from a different one.
Yeah.
Right.
And show the larger picture, know what he did.
Correct.
Take pride in that.
Right.
So you have to fight such things.
Yeah. How do you construct these characters then? How do you fill those holes? Is that a collaborative process?
Of course, there are writers, there are a lot of people. So you sit and work on it. You keep working on it. And
now, I would imagine with Tanhaji, at least he was the hero of this story. I would imagine there's a little bit more information than Uday Bhan. Did you were you also playing to the gallery, seeing that this was something you could sort of have fun with? Because that certainly is the impression one gets in the trailer. I mean, he's got the.
But that's how the character was written also.
Right.
Otherwise, I mean, we could have taken anybody else.
Correct.
We wanted Saif
mm.
only because the character was written like this, and mm. I really felt that he's the only one who can pull it off right now.
Right.
So and the kind of reactions also coming.
Yeah.
For him,
it's casting
I'm
against
very
type,
happy
yeah.
and it's fabulous.
No, but it's very lovely. I mean, it's a great, great part.
Mm.
If I think it is my best work also till
wow.
today, really. So, and it's a different kind of acting. It's rather theatrical kind
Correct.
Of role. So I was also a little, it was new for me,
mm.
but we managed something special. What did you ask? Did we make it up?
Yeah, no,
it's not a historical.
Are you
no
playing to the gallery? Is there an approach?
Completely.
Right.
Completely playing. This is, I think, where the entertainment part comes
sure.
in. I would say, you know, a lot of Ajay's part, apart from obviously the heroism and all the things he's
yeah,
done.
Yeah, just straight is, drama.
Right.
There are no layers to
is
it.
Is the responsibility and the kind of historical correctness of
Correct.
the kind of
that,
character.
That is boring.
Right, right.
So I could afford to be much more crazy and fun because, you know, he's not carrying as much responsibility to...
Correct.
Well, hopefully
no,
not. Hopefully somebody doesn't come up from Rajasthan
no.
and say, hang on.
Him too.
yeah.
Uday Bhan too.
I'm Uday Bhan's great
also, we could because it's a contemporary today's
yeah.
Times, this film. So we could play with his look,
right?
You know, improvise.
Yeah.
He should look cool and things like this, which you can't do with other with the other characters,
mm.
because there's a fixed idea of what
yeah.
they look
yeah.
like.
Right. You know, I read comments.
Especially Shivaji Maharaj must be a
has to be typical.
One, right?
Yeah.
His posture also has to be
has
that.
Has to be a certain way.
Correct.
Because people have seen that.
An interesting casting. I mean, to get Sharad Kelkar, there is a physicality. You know, I read some of the comments under
so
the trailer.
So also, we worked on his nose.
That's right, correct, because that was, yeah.
A little crooked.
Yeah. I was reading some
you
of the comments.
You should have done
Shivaji. I knew that was coming.
Were you...
I have the nose for it, apparently.
I was reading some of the comments under the trailer, and it said, a lot of people seem to think, or it's an easy reference, to channel Khilji, and said, is he playing it like Khilji? Was that ever at the back of your mind because that's... a bar had been
no,
set.
It was never at the back of my mind on the set. Whenever I play any part, I'm
yeah.
just, I've
of
never
course.
Been influenced by another actor. Or it,
sure.
I'm just trying to figure it out myself. But I do accept, and I'm quite happy to say, that Ranveer Singh, great as he is, has kind of set the bar in kind of historical
mm.
Performances in that sense. A lot of people do get compared. I'm excited to be compared. I think I've done really well.
Okay.
So I'm,
that's
I think
nice
it's cool.
way to look at it, yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. You know, Ajay, you've played a couple of...
That's good. What am I saying?
No, it's
promotion.
Nice,
promotion. Yeah, sorry.
Ajay, you've done the historical, the patriotic film before. You've a film like Legend of Bhagat Singh, very different world, of course. This is set in 17th century. That's a freedom struggle story. But is there an approach where... I mean, is there something within you that changes or something within you that you need to switch on when you're playing someone who you know is meant to be an inspiring figure?
It's just that you need to be very, very responsible.
Right.
So you have to, you can't wrong the character.
Right.
And you have to maintain that dignity. So whatever you do, you have to keep that in mind. You have to just...
Right. Does the body language change automatically? I mean, you know, you hear Shivaji, you hear, Bhagat Singh, and suddenly, you almost want to stand up, like...
It does. Like you wear a uniform and your body language completely changes.
Right.
You could be walking like this, but when you're wearing a uniform, you're always like this, you know?
Right.
It changes.
Your wife Kajol is of course playing Tanaji's wife in this. What was that like, and why was she the right person for the part? Was it
because it's not a very very lengthy role,
right. I mean,
footage wise, it's a couple of scenes, but the problem was that we needed somebody like her because imagine the sacrifice women go through.
Yeah.
When their man is leaving, and and she knows that he's not, they know that he might not come back,
right.
And still holding that pride and things like this. So those couple of scenes were very very important.
Mm.
We needed a performer. So I asked her. I said, see, it's not a very lengthy role, but this is what the problem is. And if you're ready to do it, then we can work on the scenes according to.
You think of the film, you definitely see her face also.
Yeah. And the Maharashtrian looks
right.
Very
that's
nice.
That's right. She kind of owns that.
And
yeah.
I suppose a husband-wife connect.
Correct.
In the audience's mind also.
Right.
You don't
because it's very hard to play other parts,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
To play
because there is no love story in the film.
Right.
It's just expected to be there.
Right. There's already a marriage. There's already
a
relationship.
Exactly.
Right. How did the fact that this film is being released in 3D change the way that you all had to perform, or change the actual shooting process? I mean, how did it inform that?
Not the way you need to perform. But yeah, the shooting process changes.
Mm.
You have to keep that in mind because it's a format. It's simple things. It's like you can't get into a lot of telephoto lenses
right. In
a 3D. So you have to go wide close, and you have to have foregrounds and things like this.
Right.
So when you keep that in mind, shoot, and things work out.
Sure.
And some choreography changed in the fighting. Like
Bring
things close to the camera because they said it'll really come on to the audience like that. Like when I was shooting, I didn't see a single light.
Okay.
I was amazed.
Right.
I said, what's happening here? And I looked at the thing. I've never... And Keiko, who's our DOP that Ajay brought on, was like a DJ, had a big console with light dimmers and this, that.
Right.
And the lights were somewhere up there in the sky. And you couldn't see them. Normally you have lights, like you have lights.
Yeah.
But so it was a very different shooting process as well.
You know, you are both actors, but you're also, you're also film lovers. Was there is there a sort of excitement about that? I mean, about making your first 3D film? I mean,
of course.
You remember 3D and going as watching 3D, and I mean, was that exciting?
It's like being in the Avengers.
That is true, yeah.
And also, these guys later,
right.
And all credit to these, and I say Indian technicians, because I think they have worked longer, harder for...
Right now, so there are 300 people working with me
in
my studio who, like yesterday also, I was just feeling 300 people in their open cabins and they're working. And I got out at 4 in the morning. I'm also working there. And I just walked out from the DI studio and 80% of them in their cabin only just sleeping for 2 hours and getting back and working.
Yeah.
And they're great kids.
Actually, the commitment of the film crew is just something else, right?
Yeah. So right now there are 300 people right now also working there.
Right.
It is something else. An Indian film crew is
more than,
because we've worked in England and America and we've seen the kind of unions and the hours.
Right.
These guys will give their lives and blood for, the film.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. What are you most looking forward to when the film comes out? I mean, like you said, this is an effort, a larger effort to communicate the stories that have perhaps sort of been forgotten or haven't even reached us in the history books.
Rave reviews and box office gold.
Bottom line is that.
The second one.
Both, yeah.
But yeah, the second one.
Second one first. Box office gold and rave reviews.
No, but it really looks. It looks fantastic. It looks. It also sort of challenges your typical expectation from a historical film.
I would say it's very straight. Also, it's very simple. We've not tried to complicate it. We've not tried to add extra things for insecurity. Thoda yahan pe ye create karo. We've kept it very straight. We've stayed with the emotion, the action, the drama. And we've just been there.
And she's been also really clever and brave, I feel, in her. Because there is a certain impression of the story.
Right.
And if you read the comic and stuff, like, so what they've left out is also, I think, very, very good.
Yeah, lots of things are left out, lots of things have been added also.
Yeah.
Right.
So those decisions...
So what you read in an Amar Chitra Katha wouldn't be part of the story. What,
right, right. Well, cannot wait to watch. All the best. Looking forward to lots more. And thank you, really. I feel like it is true that, you know, our stories need to be told by us. And if we don't, who will?
Exactly. So, thank you. And we need to alter our textbooks.
Correct. Looking forward to lots more. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.